Hello, people. We are going to go through the Universal Tarot. And this is Professional Edition. And welcome to my channel. And this is done by... is it US Game or is it Los Carabello? I think it's Los Carabello. I think it's Los Carabello. This is the back. And the cards are quite huge, you guys. And they are not in any order because I use them. I have used them in a live feed for readings. So this is just a show. I'm going to just show off the cards. This is the backs. This is an additional card. Yeah. And as you guys can see, all the details. And let's go to the book. Here is the book. And as you see, the book is quite big. But I think that the book is... I don't know if it's in different languages or not, because Los Carabello do have different languages, translations. And some people think, oh, that's so bad, that they do. But I think it's good because, you know, they give people a chance. They give people a chance to, from all of the, from the language, different languages that they are choosing. They give people a chance to also participate. So I think it's good, but not on the cards. They could just, have that in the book. That's enough. That should be enough. So that's the only criticism I would say about that. So let's go with with the tarot cards. And as I said, they are not in any order. So now it's just a simple flip through. And the cardstock is good. It's not too thick and too thin. It's normal. This is a normal sized card, tarot card. And as you guys can see, it's a huge difference, right? but the cardstock is okay, I have to say. Not bad at all. But they are heavy. They are easy to corner shuffle or side shuffle. So if you have small hands, this is not a deck for you. But it depends on what sort of a shuffler you are. So let's just go through the cards. First time I held them in my hands, I was like, oh, what is this? So that was my first impression, but I guess that they are okay because I have used them in a live feed on the internet, and they are quite fun. And this is, some of the picture are a little bit more close-ups on the Ryder Smith, from the Ryder Smith tarot. So, yeah. So you're going to recognize, I guess, each and every picture. And some of the cards might have different angles, like this one. Because we used to see this, in a different direction. In opposite direction, I think. So yeah, there is a bit of difference. Here is the world. Wow. Interesting. And here is the King of Swords. Here's Three of Cups. So as you see this in different angle in the Ryder Smith tarot. So it's interesting anyways. I think that they have done, and this is also another card that you see in a different angle. So yeah. if they were not so super big, it would be nice, I think. Now I wish I had more vision, because if I could trim them to a smaller size, I would truly do that. because they are huge. So here we have the tower. Here is the Empress. No, sorry. I mean the High Priestess. Well, here's the Lovers. Ace of Wands. Sorry for the mixture. Well, it happens to the best, doesn't it? Oops, sorry for this. Oh my god. Okay. This is just falling down at me. Not nice. Stand still. I'm sorry, you guys. Oh dear. Wow, that was a shaky thing, I think. I wish I could redo this, but I don't feel like it. And I'm sorry for the shakeup, truly. We're almost, you know, more than halfway through, so. And I can't pause and, you know, go back on it either. Yeah. Okay, so that's it, you guys. And again, sorry for the bump into the camera. To my phone. It happens easily. Let me know what you thought about the video. And let me know if you have this set of cards and if you're using them. And how you think or what you think about them. But I think that they are very nice, even if they are big, they are huge, but I like them. So yeah, that's the Universal Tarot.